The torrent's going to come out, but you've got to commit right now as Crowley is looking in the area.
Down. Okay, there's the wall. No vacuum follow up. Crowley's just going to run in there. The Roshan's quite low. The bolt's going to come out.
Armel's going
to
all in.
Stop this somehow. He actually managed to get the vacuum.
Crowley's got it.
Crowley grabs it. He stacks it away from Armel, and Armel dies. Crowley can come back. They've got the Doom right now on the Ursa, who's going to get surged up and starts booking it out of there. In fact, he feels confident to now put some damage on the supports. He's going to run down the Jakiro, the rest, both Gabby as well as Cuckoo. And
Signify, they want to take this fight. I don't even know if this would be that bad of a fight for them because they have complete vision in this area.
Mikey caught though. Oh, he's going to be able to immediately try and go for Swifty. The Splinter to try and save with the BKB activated by Armel. They're going to focus down this Kunkka. The boat's going to come in and they're going to be able to trade up the two supports for a big Kunkka kill. The BKB on the Weaver as well allows him to just be able to fight through these supports, and Blizzard is struggling to be able to keep his hands on one of these cores. The Weaver's a little bit too hard to get through. Same goes with
the damage.
He can't TP out either, so he is dead. TNC, they will be able to...
At least for the time being, but they're actually just going to jump back in on Armel. They're saying to themselves, they don't have the burst to kill twice.
Oh, what a beautiful vacuum, but where's the follow-up? They don't actually have any stuns to be able to get in there. In fact, it was the Centaur stun from Cuckoo that did so much more work. Cuckoo is very tanky, and Blizzard's having a hard time to be able to beat
him
down.
Nice path.
Blizzard, he dies first before Cuckoo, and Cuckoo is just taunting all of Signify. They've been wiped completely. The way this team fight is set up with TNC sitting on the high ground, they're gonna swap back the Doom. Look at that, Armel blinking forward, trying to catch something there. The nice done with the follow-up ice path as well. Signify just grouped up so much. They did manage to get the imprisonment onto Armel. They need to finish him off, and Armel does get imprisoned by that Morphling. It's gonna be safe for the moment time being, but he's come back, blinks away. Lita actually survives. Gabby's now gonna turn on to Swifty as well. Two supports dead. TNC wipe out the Terror Blade as well. Armel comes back for revenge. What a beautiful save from Gabby. And now as a result, not only
gonna wait in the corner, Crowley gonna snowball himself in, and this might have just been suicide by him.
Oh.
Roshan is not nearly low enough, and they're just throwing bodies at this pit at this point.
You know, Mr. Crowley, I can't blame you too much for that one. It worked last time.
He's trying to go for the swap. He's gonna walk in.
Can he actually get it? There's a Lincoln's that's gonna be able to prevent the stun on Gabby.
That was a very valiant.
He's going to be grabbed, not by the Night Stalker though. He's going to be imprisoned up. Armel, his BKB is just going to be left languishing here inside of the pit. Actually going to be saved by a Glimmer Cave. They don't have any counter detection. Oh no! He managed to BKB, blink away. Gabby's going to be targeted by that Terror Blade, but now the Terror Blade's going to be doomed up, controlled. Fortunately, there's going to be that imprisonment. Once again, no chance. He's trying to finish off Gabby as much as possible, but no, the waveform over to the high ground. He's going to be able to survive by swapping back over to the Terror Blade. Mr. Crowley's dead. The OT's going to come back into an imprisonment. Blink in, Rod of Atos, trying to put some damage onto No Chance as best as possible. There is going to
nice
be a snowball
dodge.
Save. Now, he still took the Laguna Blade damage, but it does give the chance for him to be able to pop his BKB and at least turn and fight, but Armel has BKB of his own. Gabby's taking a lot of damage here. Aegis not going to die just yet. They need to be able to finish off this first life with the Morphling now, otherwise they're just going to run out of time. Negi going to swap back Blizzard. It's going to be a good play because Blizzard was not controlled up by that Doom, but unfortunately he's just lacking the targets to be able to lay damage into. No one's being disabled on the side of TNC, so they're just kind of kiting him around. And that metamorphosis is going to run out eventually. Snowball to start things off onto Gabby. Walrus Punch will be able to hold him out a little bit. Blizzard goes ahead and pops his BKB, starts laying some damage into Gabby, but can't get him. The waveform managed to drift him away. No Chance is going to go for that backline as you suggested. Hits the Jakiro at first, realizes maybe Gabby's the better target here as he's actually running out of strength here. But now the BKB down on the Terror Blade, he's susceptible to the stuns. But he do manage to get a Walrus Punch onto Armel. He's taking so much physical damage.
Armel's
dead. Actually finally locked down these heroes and killed them. They will be able to get it, but they're...